this is the end for you! Give up already, you feet angel!
Hey, look over there! Isn't that the angel? She looks like she's in danger. Disgaea can sense a certain kind of event coming up.
I'm interested in seeing what Tyrant Valvatoris is gonna do.
Damn! You rebels from Hades! You're here to save the angel?
No, we're just here to bring this area under our control.
I shouldn't ignore what you just said, but first things first, we need to kill this angel.
Sure, go right ahead. I'm glad you're helping to get rid of her. We're tired of being accused of working with that angel. Right, my lord?
Right, but...
Hey, come on! She might be that Artina girl! We can't do this to her!
She's just a dirty thief. Persecuting her is the right thing to do.
That is true. She can't complain for being killed after all the things she's done around the Netherworld.
Oh, so no lovey-dovey event. Disgaea is disappointed. No! Bad party! You guys shouldn't give up on her! Jeez, demons are so...
Kill this angel and claim the reward!
Stop!
You! Is a demon trying to help an angel?
You out of your mind, my lord? This is only going to give the Corruptment more reason to bring us down. Are you going to shoulder all the crimes that angel has committed in the Netherworld? I can't afford for you to misunderstand how much this is going to affect our ability to accomplish our goal of usurping the regime. You can't seriously be seeing that thief as some woman who's already dead.
Head is telling me that she isn't the same woman, but I just can't stand here and watch that happen either.
Love can't be measured by equations, just as I read in a naughty book.
Stooping to be an angel's allies! You scum! You have no right to call yourselves demons! Now die!
Oh my god. Oh, that didn't work. Oh my god, I finally get to talk about my magic knight. Holy fuck. Oh, look, there's Volcanus just standing on the pillar over there. Volcanus, by the way, is actually the name of a villain from the first game. Odd choice for a name. I don't get her yet, she's just a... NPC, but I'm just seeing what she can do. I didn't show it because apparently I didn't record it. My bad, guys. Sorry. But, I made my Magic Knight, and I already leveled her to level 44. Her name is Arcuade, or Arcuide. That's a reference to an anime called Fate Stay Night. If you happen to have seen it. I mainly just did that because Arcuade in that anime is a vampire, actually. Really strong one. And the reason I only named her that is just because she had short blonde hair, kind of like the Magic Knight. That's it. I mean, she can't use magic, but I just like how it looks. So, I finally get to talk about that class, but before I get into that, this map, this is an intimidating map. Those witches and that rock are standing on reverse damage panels, so if you do physical attacks, it will heal them. If you attack with healing magic, it will hurt them. And I only have one healer, who I reincarnated into a green skull, which you might be curious about. I totally forgot I had done that, but the purpose was I needed to level up a skull to unlock a certain class. I believe I was working. This was when I began working towards the professor. Oh, and I made my wood golem too. Skull crush, bitches. That's right. I went to the item world and I happened to defeat a wood giant, a wood golem, and I'm like, oh, I'm definitely making him. So I spent a little bit leveling him, and there she is. Arcweed, leveling them up. They're already two of my strongest units. I was abusing the level 5 too, like I said. Again, I would have shown you, but I didn't record it. So now I finally have an excuse to talk about two of my favorite classes. Oh, look how little they have left. So yeah, Magic Knight. Let's get into it. Magic Knights look like a hybrid class between melee characters and ranged magic casters. While there is some truth in that, it's also deception. Magic Knights make rather pathetic melee characters. They simply can't deal as much damage in melee as a class with more offensive physical abilities. True. Magic Knights do well enough, but that's not really what they're meant to be. Yeah, at first, the concept was they're supposed to be a hybrid of magic and physical damage, but when you try to compensate and do both, you kind of get poor, mediocre results. So it's really just better to specialize in one or the other, and they are much better magic users than they are physical units. That attack is devastating. Oh wow, that really hurt. Does he die? Yeah, he died. Too much magic damage. Alright, instead, Magic Knights are more mobile casters with increased survivability. Yeah, they have much better defensive stats than mages do. They don't learn as many offensive spells on their own, but class changes or inheritance can assist in that department. With a good staff for intelligence, a Magic Knight can start to get big numbers with their spells. Spirit Benediction helps a great deal and should be coupled with Elemental Force. With those two abilities, you can blow down enemies quite well. That's something I mentioned numerous times already. Continue to increase your Magic Knight's elemental resistances, and thus their offense as well. So they're really good at taking magic hits, and they do increase damage as a result. If you get up to a substantial level, you may start to see Magic Knights even push beyond magician spell damage, though this takes quite some doing. Although due to their base abilities, at the highest levels, skulls will do more damage than Magic Knights, simply because they do 30% more magic damage at the cost of more SP use, whereas Magic Knights just do 20% more elemental damage. But at that crazy level, you're killing everything in one hit anyway. It's just that if you want to do the maximum damage in the game, Magic Knights can no longer do that. And Disgaea too, they had the same ability, Spirit Benediction, but it did 25% elemental damage as opposed to just 20 now. So in Disgaea 2, Space Knight, the last form, was the only class capable of doing the maximum damage in that game. In Disgaea 3, they made them slightly worse, and in Disgaea 4, they're slightly harder still. It sucks, but I've grown an affinity for the class ever since the second game. Anyway, they have a 25% resistance in all elements, so like I said, that's good for survivability. They have one more movement range than mages and skulls, so witches and skulls, so that's also handy. Cross Demon Rush! New skill. To get, you have to raise a warrior or valkyrie and magician or witch to level 30 or higher. It was just a matter of time. You're going to unlock this class because it's highly likely you're using both of those classes. Preferred weapons are swords and stabs, although I already told you which one you should be using. They have some unique... They learn up to the mega spells in every element. In the Disgaea 2 and 3, they learned up to Giga, so they're nerfing them even further. However, that's just another excuse to go into the character world with them and increase their aptitudes more. To inherit the skills. Of course, you could also do the reincarnation... Oh, there she is. Of course, you could do the reincarnation trick and just go through all of the witches, learn the spells that way, then reincarnate finally into a magic knight.
Surrender to me!
Ugh, I hate that voice. The voice is worse, too. Yeah, the Magic Knight class has a few special, a few class-specific abilities. They have the Elemental Charge, which increases, resistance, to a certain element, to any character. But inherently it's by 25%, although the more mana you put into it, the more you increase resistances by. With Elemental Force, this can be used to increase your own elemental damage, and since it lasts for a few turns, this is handy for really tough boss characters. And they also get the Anti-Element, which does the opposite and reduce elemental resistances. Of course, it's not as handy as just powering up your own stats. Let's see, we got Magic Knight. Aptitudes: HP 100, SP 110, Attack 110, Defense 90, Intelligence 110, Resistance 90, Hit 90, Speed 70. So the only thing they're really lacking in is speed. Their defenses are so much better, and as is their HP, than the other witches and mages, so their durability is much better, although still not spectacular. But with their elemental resistances, magic is going to be the least of their problems. Then we have the Dark Knight, the Rune Knight, the Mega Knight, the Force Knight, and the Space Knight, my favorite. Aptitudes for that are HP 125, SP 135, Attack 135, a totally wasted aptitude, Defense 100, imagine if those two switch, so much better, Intelligence 135, Resistance 100, Hit 100, Speed 80. So,
here I come.
Actually, that resistance stat is a lot lower than a witch's is. Although their much better HP makes up for that, I guess. Anyway, natural ability is Spirit Benediction. Increases elemental damage by 20%. That's always useful. That's a great ability. And the next one is what makes them a powerhouse. Elemental Force. Reflects the elemental value onto element attacks, only for positive resistances. So, because she starts with 25% in every element, you do 25% more damage with each one. If you use an elemental charge in your first and increase your increase it to 50%, that element will do 50% more damage. It's super useful. The next one, Echo, a 25% chance to use the same special skill in a row. Really good for high damage purposes. And I'm told there's a way to manipulate it so that you can use two spells every single time. I'm not sure what the trick is, I haven't looked into it, but if anybody wants to let me know, that would be awesome. And the last one is useless, Sword Force. 30% of base attack is added to intelligence if the sword is equipped. Theory is, if you use a sword, the increase in your base intelligence will let you use magic just as well. Although staves also increase your intelligence stat much further, and without a staff, your magic range will be pathetic. So employ them as I mentioned, make them kick-ass magic users. It's what they excel at. This map's winding down. So you can see why I like them. And I believe eventually I go into the character world and I teach them a healing spell as well, simply because several maps I clear with my Magic Knight on my own, with Arcoid on her own, and you know, she can't tank damage, but she can absorb enough hits where she can recover all her health in a single turn and make up for it. Where did I drop that? Oh, here it is. Take that. So it's handy that way. The purpose for my... Yeah, the skull was I was trying to make a sorcerer, which was eventually required to make... No, not a sorcerer. What are they called? Well, I'll get back to it into a bit. Enjoy the cutscene.
This guy. I heard you're a former pretty instructor. How can you be so strong?
Former? I'm still an active pretty instructor.
Displaying such strength, even after losing most of his power, as expected of my lord, would be invincible once he regains his power. I must do whatever it takes to make that happen. But before that, I must eliminate all unnecessary factors.
It's happening! Now those two will finally be...
I hope you don't think you saved me or anything.
No, that wasn't my intention. I was merely suppressing those who resist our invasion of this area.
I'm glad. I don't intend on paying you back for your help, which I never asked for.
What the hell's going on? Is she really an angel?
I've never heard of such a greedy angel before. Hence her nickname, Avarice.
She's the complete opposite of purity. Could she really be the wrong lady?
But you did save me after all. Saying thanks is free, right? I guess I should thank you.
I said it was unintentional. I don't need your unappreciative thanks. That aside, what do you think you're doing, engaging in theft in the Netherworld? You keep bringing up money. How bad is the economy in Celestia?
Oh, please. What I'm doing is not theft. I'm carrying out collection in the name of justice.
Collection?
Sure, it's true that the offerings from the human world have decreased, along with peace and order, and we're struggling to gather enough funds to keep Celestia in working order. But that's all because the demons are slacking off, and humans have stopped being afraid of them. They've stopped believing in God. So I'm only here to collect the money that was supposed to be coming to Celestia in the first place.
Hey, now! That kind of logic isn't gonna work here!
Whether it will or not, I don't really care. I didn't expect you all to understand in the first place. Oh, and one more thing. My operation isn't sanctioned by Celestia. I'm doing this all on my own.
Who cares if you're doing this by yourself? What do you intend to use that kind of money for?
Why should I tell you that? How much will you give me if I do? Time is money. I don't have any more time to waste.
Whoa! What's this? Ah! Big sis! Disgaea can't see!
Good day, everyone!
Where'd that angel go? Did she get away? We must go after her!
My lord, please, wait. Our goal is to take control of this area. I suggest we ignore that thief for now.
She said she's not a thief. She claimed her actions are justified and that we demons are to blame.
That was just her way of defending herself. We don't have time to make stops if we're to accomplish our goal, my lord.
I know!
Fine. She's probably headed to the largest vault in the area. I'm sure our paths will cross again. If that is the case, What do you intend to do when they do?
Well,
Will you promise me one thing? If she becomes an obstacle, you will use force to eliminate her.
It seems like that angel is a real eyesore for Fenric. I mean, it's natural for demons to despise angels, but...
That's not the only reason. It's called jealousy. Jealousy. That's the source of all negative energy in females.
And just who is jealous of whom, huh? Is there a problem, my lord? Are you putting the well-being of that angel over usurping the regime?
That is absolute nonsense! Fine. If she ever gets in the way of us accomplishing our goal, I won't hesitate to take her down.
Okay then, my lord. That is a promise.
Indeed. It is a promise.
Aw, man. Falsey totally fell for Fenfen's scheme.
Oh! What's gonna happen to his love?
Don't look at me!
Yeah, this is another case where the next scene has no... has no story, so I'm doing a twofer. Although it's another annoying level. Well, I'll explain in a bit. Yeah, but, no, what was that class called again? A...
Where would you be without me?
Is it a sorcerer? No, it's... They used to be called witch doctors. Now they're called... Oh, sorcerer. Okay. In fact, I think I'm going to reincarnate him right now. I also learned wind... just so I could do some damage. There it is. A sorcerer who spreads misfortune, lowers the power of all enemies. Should I do this class, or should I do the wood golem? I was debating whether to actually do it or not. As you can see, the aptitudes aren't that great. But I needed to make one anyway.
Woohoo! Yeah. Honey? Pow! Bunny! Oh! Bunny! Oh! Ah! Oh! Oh!
That's the awesome thing about the shaman. They don't say anything, it's just gibberish. So cute. They used to say things in the third game, which was when they first came about.
Woohoo!
Woohoo! So I level her up for a bit just to unlock another class. Although, I wanted to learn all of her debilitating skills while I was in there. Yeah, you know what, sure. I just made her. I'll save the wood golem for another day. Let's go into the Sorcerer. How to unlock? Raise a Magician and a Witch to level 15 or higher. So I had to make... So I reincarnated my healer into a Skull, the Magician, so that I could unlock this class. So that I could eventually unlock the Professor. In fact, this is the character I turn into a Professor later. Eventually. It took a lot of reincarnating to get all these skills. But enough about that. Sorcerer. Sorcerers are a classic ailment class. Probably like the human version of the rock, although... pretty different at the same time. More magic-based. Can't stop the rock. Can't stop the rock. They don't do much to kill enemies, but they make it much easier for the rest of your party to get the job done. Using negative status of... Okay, we'll take a break. Oh, no, right, there's no story. Onward I go. Using negative status effects and abilities that decrease enemy stats and resistances. Sorcerers are their best in larger battles. The more allies and enemies involved, the more these percentage differences add up over the course of a fight. This map sucks because of the no ranged, and because this steep vertical climb affects your I hadn't gotten into it, but a lot of skills have a maximum differential of height. Yeah. And if the differential exceeds what you can do, the attack won't hit. Magic is nice in that it has a huge height differential.
No trunk is unsnappable.
Well, golems never used to speak.
Now they do.
So because of no ranged, I have to rely on physical close range attacks.
How do I go about this?
I mean, you can use magic, but you have to be point blank. Oh, yeah. Ugh. I hate bouncers. They always stand next to each other. Damn it, Fenric. Alright, let's see here. Where was I? Yes, the sorcerer. It's wonderful to have all four abilities from this class so that you can choose which to prepare for a specific battle. Ominous Dancer. Okay. We should read these descriptions before I continue. Their base ability, Cursed Dance, decreases the stats of all enemies on the map by 5%. That doesn't sound like much at first, and it's not useful at first that much, but the stronger your enemies become, the bigger that 5% drop is going to be. Not to mention, it compounds, so if you have four sorcerers and you deploy them all the enemy stats are going to be lowered by 20%, no matter where they are. Then they have Hazard Dance, increases the chance of ailments to work against enemies by 20%. If you're going to be using a sorcerer to cast these kind of debuffs, obviously you're going to want to equip that. So yeah, I have her on the field. Now all the enemies' stats are decreased by 5%. Had I done it beforehand, I might have killed a lot of those enemies sooner. Then we have Ominous Dance. Decreases the evasion of enemies by 20%. Again, really useful for those very evasive enemies. If you're only going to use a sorcerer to deploy and not use, teach it this ability. And the last one is Ruin Dance. Decreases the elemental stats of enemies by 25%. Yeah, that's also handy. Wow, just imagine having... Make two sorcerers, equip one with each of those abilities and deploy them. And if you use a lot of magic characters, they're just going to... Wreck shop, clean up house, and other idioms? Is that what they're called? Anyway, back to the description. Ominous Dance really helps against high speed enemies. Rune Dance lets your caster shine. Hazard Dance makes your sorcerer have more chances to disable targets. They're all fairly good during the mid game. Later on, when killing an enemy outright becomes the only real way to win, sorcerers lose some of their luster. Even then, having something that reduces enemy stats by 5% can make a difference when you're dealing with bosses that have high stats and powerful equipment. Yeah, pretty much. So it's kind of funny because their usefulness is on a bell curve. They're not that useful at first. I mean, their spells can kind of come in handy. But in the mid-game where their stat lowering makes a bigger difference... Until the very end game where everything gets killed in one hit anyway. How funny how that works. Only in Disgaea, folks. Alright, they can use spears and staves, although their aptitudes don't lend well to spears at all. 50% resistance to fire, no wind resistance, and 25% resistance to ice. That's decent. Let's see. We have the Shaman. That's the base. HP aptitude 80, SP 120, attack 100, defense 100, intelligence 120, resistance 110, hit 90, speed 90. Mediocre. Again, they're not damage dealing units. How do you like that wood axe? Wood golems used to become fists. Now it's a axe. That makes more sense, if you ask me. Although their wood fist skills in the third game were awesome. Brain shaker. I'll check this out. Ow! Would you like just having a growing an arm and then just slabbing him in the face? Anyway, we got the shaman, the witch doctor, the necromancer, the dark elder, the purgatory oracle. That's fancy. And the soul invoker. Aptitudes for that are HP 90, speed SP 145, attack 125, defense 125, intelligence 145, resistance 135, hit 100, and speed 100. Wow, that's actually a significant improvement. All in all, this class has its charm and its uses. It's just a matter if it's for you or not. Again, this game has so many viable options and playstyles. But if you find yourself... I have a bad habit of making too many direct damage dealing units. It probably would have been better if you focus on 4 primary damage dealers. And then 4 to 5, I would say, because it's hard to focus on more than that. Then have all these auxiliary characters, like have a few monsters for magic changing and fusion, and then have support classes like healers and shamans, or, you know, maybe like the rock class or the flora beast. And I think you might find, I mean, because some maps in this game just do not lead to direct damage strategies at all. You really need to use your head. And, you know, like I said, professors, they eliminate a lot of the challenge, actually, from the X-Dimension maps, because their skills is like, my movement isn't high enough. Well, let's equip 3 pairs of shoes and increase your movement by 3. Followed by the movement spell, so now your movement is 6 higher. Suddenly, this map isn't so difficult. You know, a lot of stuff like that. But a lot of people don't even think about that. Ugh, her resistance stat is so low, and she can't heal for shit, unlike when she was a healer, obviously. But she only has the basic heal spell. Goddamn, no ranged. Might as well be silence. It's pretty much the same thing. Nah, it's really not. Silence is so much worse. And again, at least you can... Oh my god, I accidentally attacked Fenric. That really could have screwed me over if... How did I do that? I think it was... Is the bouncer too high to attack? Because that can be the case, and then the only one in range was Fenric, and so I attacked him instead. Oh my god. That could have been so stupid. I mean... Does Desko die? No, thank God. Heaven forbid Desko die.
There it is. Desko is getting excited.
What, you see why I hate this map? This roller coaster isn't fun at all. More brain shaker. Ugh, even with a critical. So I'm not to kill him. Yeah. That magical vest accessory is nice because it's a defense item that also increases your intelligence a little bit. God damn it. Magic Knights, their defense is good enough. Give them a good piece of defense. Give them an orb. Here I go! to increase your SP and resistance, which lets them heal better and cast more spells. And then finally, well, I have a pair of glasses on at the moment just because their hit is decent, but you really need to hit with spells.
Excuse me.
Oh man, this witch is not surviving this. It'd be funny if they just kept it. I was gonna say. And the final one, an emblem, which increases all stats, would be handy.
Point?
Point? What, she thinks she's a slime? Boing!
Yeah, I'm a slime, so what? Teen Girl Squad!
That's what that reminded me of. God, I haven't watched Tomb Star Runner since high school. Which was like 10 years ago for me.
I'm an old fag.
Again, no wonder she her healing is so weak. She's level 1. I didn't do anything to level her up. See, in the later level, it's so much easier to level up weaker units later because you can just, like, giant magic change them and suddenly they're super powerful and they can defeat weakened enemies from behind. By the way, whoever posted that comment back in Chapter 5-1 about Desko in Japanese, I could read that, and thank you. Now I know how they spell. It was spelled in katakana. So, it's just conjecture, but still likely that, that her name is, like, Death Kid. Or something like that. God damn it, bouncers are so hard to kill. Of course, if I made a bouncer, it would die in one shot. Or something like that. But yeah, one slight problem with magic knights is that they require a shitload of mana. Mana for learning skills from the character world. Mana for boosting all of their magic. And, you know, you want to use all their magic because they're good with all of it, so you definitely want to put them in the evil pyramid group to increase their mana gain. Put them in the same group as Valvatoris is going to be killing a lot of shit anyway. And one other person, probably Desko. Put Valvatoris, Desko, and a magic knight together like I did, and they will get obscene amounts of mana. Unfortunately, I'd like to say that I'm at the part of the game where mana is becoming much easier to accumulate. Ugh, just 4 more bouncers and they're done. I don't even understand the purpose of the no lifting part on the roller coaster. Is that really that much of a detriment? I don't think it is at all. Well, I can just barely hit him. Cool as that is nothing compared to, like, X/Fury or whatever it was called from the third game. That attack was nuts.
There.
Seems to have quite a bias for a lot of the third game, even though I like this one and 2 a lot more than 3. I guess it just had a lot of cool attacks. Every single Disgaea game has had crazier and crazier attacks than the one before it. Like, I look at the weapon skills from the first game, and they're, like, so plebeian and boring in comparison. I'm not kidding. Go, like, watch a weapon skill exhibition from the first game. It's like, Yawn. Not to mention the difference in graphics from like those low-res sprites. Even the difference between Disgaea 1 and 2 is pretty severe. Counter Wars. Wow, that just kept going. See, I power level a lot of my characters, and I'm still having a tough time. Imagine how hard this would have been otherwise. No ranged. I'll show you. Spirit Bomb! Not even. Is his name Adonis? It is! It's the not-so-dark Adonis! Wow. If you played the first game, you would understand that reference. This game has references out the wazoo. The wazoo! One more turn. Really?
Here I come.
And that's the end of that chapter. Thank God. Ooh, legendary items.